Despite its dovish stance, Fitch Solutions sees the Philippine Central Bank raising interest rates this year to contain inflation. Fitch says the BSP may hike rates by 75 basis points to 2.75 from a record low of 2%. That's due to the combination of inflationary pressures, continued economic recovery, and major central banks ending their pandemic-era easy monetary policy. The BSP has kept key interest rates at 2% since November of 2020 to help the Philippine economy weather the impact of the pandemic. Fitch Solutions also raising its 2022 inflation forecast for the Philippines to 4.5%, that is above government's target range of 2 to 4% due to soaring global oil prices. The Philippine Transportation Department stands pat on its stance not to approve any fare adjustments or fuel surcharge hike for airlines despite high oil prices. Jackie Manabat reports.
The aviation industry is still reeling from the impacts of the pandemic. They put out promo fares to encourage the passengers to book flights. Passengers have started doing so for the summer. But they're facing another challenge, the global problem on high price of crude oil. Current fuel surcharge is based on the two-month average of Min of Platts Singapore or MOPS jet fuel from December 2021 to January 2022. This covers prices until next month or April. The price of crude oil has since increased by over $100 per barrel since start of the year. The Civil Aeronautics Board held a meeting on Monday to hear a local airline's appeal to adjust the fuel surcharge, but no resolution was reached. But according to Transportation Secretary Art Gade, there will be no fuel surcharge adjustments for now.
Wala munang increasean. Kaya yung fuel surcharge, oho, sinisipat at sinisilip yan. Nabanggit sa akin yan, ang knee-jerk reaction ko is, pag-aralang mabuti yan, pagkat, pag nag-fuel surcharge ka, kaibigan, sino ang bibit-bit ng gastusin na yun? Yung pasahero.
Philippine Airlines earlier said it wants to ask for a review of the fuel surcharge.
We're actually asking the help of CAB for our fuel surcharge, but of course, it should be still reasonably priced for the consumers to actually not reasonable for them to fly.
Cebu Pacific says it's not yet time to ask for a fuel surcharge.
We think traveling is a habit. So our initial objective is to get people back on planes, get used to flying again. Thus, we're intentionally keeping our fares very attractive and competitive in order to stimulate traffic. No? It's more important for us that people get back into the habit of traveling.
Meanwhile, AirAsia Philippines says they have not been charging the passengers the fuel surcharge for years.
As a matter of fact, there were times na hindi po kami nag-implement ng fuel surcharge. For example, noong 2015, no? Wala po tayong fuel surcharge doon. Tumaas pero hindi po naningil ang AirAsia Philippines.
Fuel surcharge could be seen on the breakdown of the air ticket. Airlines could decide whether to collect a lower surcharge than the published rates or none at all for a competitive advantage. Jackie Manabat, ABS-CBN News.
Two Philippine presidential bets hold separate talks with representatives from billionaire Elon Musk's SpaceX. First up, Manila Mayor Isko Moreno. He hopes to buy some 1,000 satellite dishes from the firm and install them in schools, hospitals, and government centers in Manila. Senator Manny Pacquiao also met with SpaceX officials. This is the second meeting between Pacquiao and the company's top executives for this year as they discuss possible partnerships to improve internet service across the Philippines. Power utility giant Meralco prepares contingency plans in case of unexpected power interruptions during the May 9 elections and canvassing nights. The details from Alvin El Chico.
Meralco has already procured 250 generator sets and around 500 floodlights in case power interruptions occur during election and canvassing nights. It also has purchased several portable LED lights, which are more handy than the generator-powered floodlights. The country's largest power utility is readying contingency measures, though it cannot categorically declare that no power interruption will happen this election week or the entire summer.
Mahirap sabihin, Alvin, kasi sabi ko nga sa iyo, nandun lang kami sa distribution side, no? But as far as the distribution side is concerned, I can assure you that we are ready and able to respond to any situation.
The National Grid Corporation has again raised the alarm over the possibility of power outages after the Luzon grid plunged into yellow alert or thin power reserve for 5 hours last Saturday until 11 p.m. Seven power plants bogged down, shaving off over 2,000 megawatts from the power grid. The grid operator worries that unplanned shutdowns have become more frequent as temperatures rise and the election week draws near.
On paper, maganda, sapat ang nakikita nating supply versus dun sa nakikita natin na posibleng maging peak o yung demand, yung kataasan ng demand. Kaso lang, nakikita rin natin na dumadalas na yung mga unplanned outages o yung mga maintenance shutdowns.
But the Energy Department says there's no need to worry.
Hindi naman siya alarming. And may nakikita tayo mga solution. For example, for any possible na kakulangan ng reserves natin, meron tayong malaking unit that will be available at magkoconduct ng testing and commissioning. Nakaready sila towards the end of April and most likely by May, mag-start na ng testing and commissioning yon.
The problem is, no one can predict when a power plant will bog down, which can result to yellow or red alerts, which translate to rotational power interruptions.
Maraming pagkakataon na yung maintenance shutdown, humahaba, nag-extend sila, o di kaya naman, biglaan, wala pa sila sa schedule, bigla na lang talagang titirek, or nakikita nila na hindi na nila maipagpapaliban maski wala pa sila sa schedule. So those Correct. Are the things we have to watch.
Meralco has also set its interruptible load program where some commercial or industrial customers use its own power generators instead of getting electricity from the grid.
Based on the data, we have mga 560 megawatts, which comprises around 122 customers.
Okay. So yan, ready yan? Anytime?
Anytime. Yellow, red, pasok na yan.
The public is also asked to use energy efficiently, just like the mandatory energy-saving measures in government offices. Alvin Olchico, ABS-CBN News.